we have always informed them even about the dangers of the junk foods and how is it that these specific foods in the near future would be creating havoc even on the lives of our children. And now, as I was saying yesterday also, that the most discomforting thing is that we don't even pay attention as parents. I say parents does only pay the rent. Yes, pay the rent and give the child a house. But the morals when it comes to disciplining and understanding and teaching a child that their behaviors, whether it is affecting them or if it is making them more holistically sound, you understand? So we are presently seeing a trend even within society that children are obese, children are overweight. And I'm talking about obese, people that are they call it fat, gua, gues. Now, what we used to refer to that before as is, okay, bagay bel. So if somebody used to be fat and round and plump, it used to be bagay bel. Why? Because even the non-communicable chronic illnesses, like your diabetes, hypertension, all these things, even prostate cancer, most of these are their lifestyle diseases. Our activities, fibroids, all these things are lifestyle diseases. What you would see is that these types of diseases were reserved for what we call the upper class people, the people who could afford to buy the pork, the people who could afford to buy the ham, the people who could afford even to have the chicken and these things on the table every single day. But even the people right here in Dominica that live up to about 100 years, 110 years, 120 years, what happened is that these people, the diets of these people were completely different from what our children are eating today. I don't pass by these fast food restaurants not once. Most times when I pass, I purposefully look through the windows and see how many people are inside to see what are the people of Dominica eating. And these places are always packed up. And on the news they said that Antigua has 40%, if you have to consider overweight obesity. I saw the doctor talking about it, in children from 0 to 5. That is from 0 to 5. That's basically like babies. You have 40% obesity, you have 6% high cholesterol, you have hypertension, you have diabetes in these young children. What is it that we are going to do to help our children to overcome that drastic barrier? Because if it is that your child develops your condition as a mother or what your grandmother developed at 60 or at 50 or at 40, maybe you got diabetes when you're 45. If your child is getting diabetes by the time that they are 5, that means that by the time that they are 15, they might have already had an amputation. You understand? So what we are looking at is something drastic that is happening within the whole world, not only in Dominica. But the thing is that where is it that we are going to move forward with the information that we have received? And my major concern as the lecture that I will be giving tonight at the Fortium Hotel from 5 p.m., we will be addressing what is the conventional methods of treating these diseases. What is it that they're gonna do? What the doctor's gonna do? I mean, if you bring the 5-year-old child to a doctor and they have diabetes, the doctor is inclined to do what he knows to do. He's gonna prescribe them something to help to bring down the sugar. I mean, if their kidneys do go bad, they're gonna go on dialysis. That is exactly what is going to happen. Then we are going to have children beginning consuming pharmaceutical drugs at such a tender age, unless we do the obvious, we examine what is the cause of these diseases. Why is it that my child is overweight? What does that mean? How at risk is my child of getting a heart attack? I mean, if a child has high cholesterol and the child is 5, they are at as much as risk as a man at 60 or at 45. So our children are at risk of getting all these diseases. And what we have to keep in mind specifically is that questioning the existing system, questioning whether it is something that is effective, is not a crime. It is not wrong to question whether the way that we are doing something is helping us or destroying us. You know, a good leader is one that will take decisions that people might consider to be bad, but in the long term, they could reap the benefits. So when we question the methods that is going to be implemented to deal with the problems that we must have, because you are going to have children getting heart attacks, you are going to have children getting strokes, you are going to have little girls getting fibroids from 13, 10, 7, you are going to have all these things. Why? Because you already have young girls at the age of 13, 14, already on birth control pills for what we call polycystic ovarian condition, where they have multiple cysts in the ovaries. Why? Because of hormonal imbalances. Where they get these hormones from? From the food that they actually consume. Yes, previously, while we have been here in Dominica, we have dealt with the foods that people are consuming to get them sick. Now, what we are going to look at in this lecture, even today at the Fort Young Hotel from 5 p.m., we are going to be looking at the methods that conventional medicine, allopathic medicine, they are using even towards dealing with this condition. Are they effective? So the question I'm asking is that, I heard the chief epidemiologist talking about the condition of health. I saw on the, even last time on the news again, I heard they're talking about health. Okay then. So if it is that we've been treating diabetes for the past 15 years with a drug, what information, what statistics do we have to say, well, this drug has been doing the job that it claims to be doing? Then if it is that we are not in a position to pull up such evidence and say, yes, we are getting results from the way that we have been trying to deal with diabetes, or you could look at it like that and say, boy, I mean, we've been doing this for over 15 years and the number of diabetics are going up. I mean, and people that started taking the drug from 10 years ago, they're still taking it, but they're not getting better. Is it that we are doing the right thing? It is important that we question these things, and then we could be in a position to say, okay, let us plan a different route towards helping our people get better, because that's the objective. You know, there will always be a job for a doctor. If a doctor get a patient well, that doesn't mean that they won't have a job. You know, because the patient would always need someone to motivate them. So when you go to your doctor, the doctor says, oh, Sydney, how are you doing today? Oh, I'm good, doc. I mean, I did what you recommended last week and I'm feeling so much better. But as you know, I need to keep this up. What do you think that I should do more to make myself feel holistically well? Prophylactic medicine, you know, giving information to prevent disease. So just like you have a car, and even if you're concerned, your car always needs a little service to clean and to do something. Yes, you would always need a physician, someone to counsel you, to guide you, to motivate you. You know, because we're human beings. The doctors will still have jobs. Priscilla, yeah, bless her. Yeah, Mokopan. We Mokopan. Yes, I understand.